neuralgias in the legs, numbness, tingling.
If I walk a long distance, like on that stress test I did here about 2 weeks ago, well, hell yeah.
Okay. Just like achy muscles or like numbness?
No, just
achy muscles.
Like my legs are going to fall off.
Okay.
And your hip starts hurting.
Okay. But no numbness or tingling or weakness or anything like that? No. Just old age?
Yes.
All right. Now, what about any heart problems? You had that stress test and everything looked good with that. So no other heart problems? Your blood pressure looks good?
My test looked all right.
That's from what I read. No one told you that?
You know more than
Yeah.
If you read it, you read it.
Yeah, I read it. It looked good.
I didn't read it. I was just told it.
No, I was impressed. You passed.
Oh, really?
Yes, sir. All right, so no valve, heart valve problems, nothing like that. No history of any type of cardiac issues.
Not really,
no heart stents, no heart attacks, no nothing.
Until yesterday.
What happened yesterday?
I had that procedure.
Uh-huh.
I've never been to the hospital.
So this is all new one for you.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, we're glad to have you.
Oh, yeah. Welcome to the club.
Unfortunately, under these circumstances, but...
No, I'm proud to be here under these circumstances.
But like I said, hey, at 95% blockage, you're very lucky you don't have any symptoms from it, and it's very lucky to go ahead and get it done now before you do have symptoms of it.
She was a little worried about it.
Worried about the procedure?
A little bit.
I mean, it's a big procedure. She's allowed to be worried.
Tell her how good
that's just love. Dr. Caffey is excellent. Very good surgeon, does a lot of these. Okay, we monitor him the entire time. We check his blood pressure. We continuously monitor him as soon as we wake up. We make sure he's moving everything and talking and everything.
Okay, he's going to wake up with 20-year-old veins.
That's the plan. At least one 20-year-old vein.
One.
So you don't have any like claudication in your legs, no other vascular problems.
I just had my check. On my legs check today.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so we don't know.
No.
We don't know.
They haven't even got the results.
Nobody said anything.
They don't really make you have a stroke.
Well, not everything's been transcribed yet, so yes. You just have a very limited history of the computer. Because they have to talk to in the phone, and then you got to get someone to type it all up, and then put it back in the computer, so sometimes it takes a while. So that's why that part wasn't in the computer. I saw your echo and all that, but... What about lung problems?
On my leg, you saw the echo?
No. I saw the echo of your heart.
Oh, okay.
But I didn't see anything on your legs yet. They must not have typed that up yet. Okay. Breathing problems. Asthma, COPD, shortness of breath. Mm-hmm. So even when you're doing the stress test and walking around, you weren't short of breath. You could feel it in your legs as far as being achy, but not short of breath.
Way before I felt anything in my lungs. I told them that when I stepped on it, I knew that already.
Okay. Are you active at all? I mean, do you walk pretty regularly or exercise or?
Yes.
Okay. All right. No sleep apnea, snoring? Does he snore?
Hell no, I don't snore.
Yes, he's anywhere, anytime, but she still snores.
She said that there was some lies.
See, he could be sitting in his chair, go sleep.
All right. Now, so no kidney problems.
All I can tell you is what my Dr. Hickman told me after my blood test last, all my numbers, kidney, liver, cancer,
thyroid,
everything,
no diabetes, no nothing like that. Okay. No acid reflux?
No, I haven't had it in a long time.
Okay. Do you take any medicines at home?
No, you did, but you quit taking.
What medicines were you taking?
Start with an R. Rotidine.
Ranitidine for sinuses?
No, it was for
heartburn.
Started with an R.
Zantac. Yeah.
No, not Zantac. That's a G.
No, but it is another. That's the brand name for what you're talking about.
It's almost what you said.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Type it in my handy dandy little.
Yeah, it was.
He prescribed it to me, and I determined that it was making me get fat.
This one, brand name Zantac.
Ritalin. Yep.
Yep.
That's it.
Yeah, for heartburn.
That's it.
Okay, so you hadn't taken that in a while.
No.
And you hadn't had any trouble. Okay, and that was the only medicine you were taking? Making me look like I didn't do my job here because I don't have a lot of X marks on this little thing.
Anyway, he prescribed me that because I told him I had acid reflux. And then about a month and a half after I took it, I told him, I said, what are you giving me that made me put weight on? He said, nothing. So, you know, I'm a physician. I said, okay, I don't need this heartburn medicine. I'm going to take it. And I lost 20 pounds that I put on. So, storytelling.
That's like antidepressants.
Well,
he didn't know, I don't think.
Well, anything that makes your tummy feel better will probably make you eat more food. So anything that keeps you from getting heartburn and keeping you from getting upset stomach. You never had surgery before, right? How much do you smoke? How many packs a day do you smoke?
Probably 2 packs.
And how many years have you smoked?
Probably 41.
Do you drink?
No, ma'am.
Do you ever have any blood disorders, bleeding problems, clotting problems?
No. When I first started taking my blood thinner, mm-hmm. or my blood pressure medicine, mm-hmm. I seemed to bleed a little more than normal, but it seems to have subsided.
Okay, what blood pressure medicine were you taking?
Lisinopril.
The lisinopril?
Mm-hmm. But that was, what, 3 years ago now?
Yeah.
But I don't scratch and bleed very easily at all now. But she doesn't either, and she used to bleed.
So you have a history of having high blood pressure, and it's controlled with the lisinopril?
For 3 years, yeah.
And no problems with that?
No. Not so far.
And never had a blood transfusion?
I would have something bad wrong with me.
Well, we just asked. We just asked.
I have a question.
Yeah.
What's my blood type? Is it on?
I don't know. Mm-mm. You have a little red band on? A little red blood band? They haven't typed you yet. When they send, they'll have you a little red band on there, and that means they typed and crossed for your blood. So they haven't done it yet. They'll probably do it in the morning for you. So, but you can ask them in the morning. They'll have it for you. Alright, so any objections to receiving blood products in an emergency?
What's your blood?
Okay. Any family history of having any complications with anesthesia? Slow to wake up, allergic reactions,
A-negative?
Anything like that? Any blood
relatives? His is A-negative?
Not that I'm aware of. They're sitting all right here.
But yeah. He
had our immediate family.
Three blood tests when we got married back then. You had to take blood tests.
Oh.
And no blood thinners like aspirin?
They don't do that anymore.
I do take the baby aspirin every day.
That's the reason why I didn't mind beside that blood test.
All my medication was on the paper I just filled out.
I was pregnant with you. I had to go make my own blood.
They didn't give me that paper again on my wallet.
You must have just got here recently because none of this is it. Did you just get here a little bit ago?
No, I didn't give it to somebody here today.
I'm sure you did. It's just not in your chart yet.
This is what I could.